very warm welcome to you on this most pleasantly clear evening. As you can see, we are getting through the pre-match formalities and processes, the players coming onto the field for the usual fanfare and handshakes and so on. Conditions absolutely perfect. Temperatures are kind enough. It is an absolute picture under the floodlights here, and the match that follows ought to follow suit. This is the very high-tech Veltins Arena, somehow fitting for this part of the world, the industrial hub that is the region of Westphalia. The national anthem of Argentina rings out. We stand for the national anthem of France. Game this between two very high quality sides, a treat for everybody here.
Well, on the face of it, Peter, we would appear to have a high caliber meeting with very little at stake, but then you consider a chance for one or two of the fringe players to get a look in, and this becomes a big incentive. It changes the dynamic, so there's plenty at stake for them, which will do no harm to the energy levels and the overall conviction and hopefully the style of contest.
Off we go then. So Jim, tell me this, who are you looking for in particular here?
This one's a no-brainer. It's got to be Lionel Messi. In my opinion, he's the best I've ever seen. No better side on a football pitch than when he's dribbling through defences and finding the corner of the net. A little genius.
Yes, they'll certainly be leaning heavily on him. Mercado, Dybala, Di Maria. Gets wrestled off the ball. Now it's Griezmann. He's got through. Now it's Giroud. And he's surging through, striding forward, facing goal. Dybala.
It can only get better, this. We haven't seen a shot yet, and I'm hoping that when we do, it'll spark a whole series of them, because it needs livening up.
Chance to shoot. He's had a goal! Goal! France! And France are in front.
France are really pouncing on any stray passes in midfield. We're talking seconds from interception to the back of the net. It's counter-attacking heaven.
France get themselves into the lead.
Yeah, and they know there's plenty of work left in this one, Peter, before they can actually say that the job is over.
Messi. Ball's loose, who's getting there? And it's Lamar. Now it's Giroud. Giroud! Iniesta. They have done it again.
Giroud versus the keeper, and only one winner.
Peter, I can tell you, that was nothing short of a cold-blooded execution.
Things starting to look very comfortable.
No doubt as to who has the momentum here now. The only doubt is how many is coming.
Di Maria. Now it's Higuain. He's got away. Big chance! And that would have been some goal.
Oh, that's an excellent try, and once he picked it up, he headed forward with real intent.
Dybala. It's a throw in. Higuain. Going for goal!
Mondi.
It's been intercepted, and that will come to nothing.
Messi. And it's Giroud.
Now it's Griezmann. And it's half-time here. Any strong opinions on the first half?
Well, they had their opponents reeling in that half, Peter, and the break may influence a change somehow, but don't hold me to it.
France in control at half-time, 2-0. We're underway again. Dybala. Higuain. Messi. Griezmann pushes it out wide. He's left his man. Mbappe. Di Maria. Dybala. And it's Salvio. Messi. France are two up. Now it's Griezmann. Mascherano does well to read it and intercepts. Mercado goes looking. Forward it goes. Back to the keeper. Keeper's got good distance on that.
Mondi.
Lamar. Mbappe. Argentina keeping their men at arm's length here.
Yeah, I just think it's a conservative move to deny runners the opportunity of going beyond that rear guard.
It's Griezmann! It's in, and that looks to me very much like an own goal.
Oh, it's terribly unfortunate for them, and maybe we can attribute that to a loss of focus.
Checks on the touchline, a change about to occur.
fortuitous as it may have been, they all count one. Mbappe, great challenge. Going through. Oh, he's put too much on it. Di Maria. Out to the left it goes. He's got away. Now it's Dybala. Now it's Aguero. Giroud pushes to get on the end of it. Mbappe. Plays it forward. There is the final whistle. France, comfortable winners. A virtuoso display, utterly one-sided. What are your thoughts on today's game then, Jim?
Well, it was engaging, if not an edge of your seat encounter. And importantly, it offered the right result.
So many thanks to Jim Beglin. That's all we have time for. Good evening to you.